The Peanut Butter Falcon is a 2019 film written and directed by Tyler Nielsen and Michael Schwartz. It's a modern take on Mark Twain's classic, The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. It's the story of Zack, played by Zack Gottsagen, a young man with Down syndrome who escapes his nurtured life at Virginia State Care Home so he can train to become a professional wrestler at the North Carolina Wrestling School run by his hero, the Saltwater Redneck. En route, Zack crosses paths with another fugitive, Tyler, played by Shia LaBeouf, a local crabber, who after losing his job sets ablaze his rival stock and goes on the lam. Tyler agrees to accompany Zack on his journey, and they both set off towards the Saltwater Rednecks Wrestling School. Close to their heels are the rival crabbers Tyler wronged, and Zack's carer Eleanor, played by Dakota Johnson. As their friendship blooms, Tyler takes on the role of Zack's trainer and life coach, transforming Zack into his wrestling alter ego, the titular Peanut Butter Falcon. A quick spoiler warning for ahead, I did try to keep it as spoiler free as possible, but there's a few things I want to discuss from the third act. Just a really simple start to this review. I love it, it's a great film, really enjoyable ride, and you come out feeling really good about yourself. Usually this wouldn't be my kind of thing. I have some kind of toxic masculinity towards anything in the feel-good genre, but I don't think you can find anything wrong about something so kind-spirited and heartwarming. That isn't to say this film's overly agreeable, however, as it does address some pretty difficult subject matters, such as grief, loss, and disability. As far as I'm aware, this is the first time I've seen an actor with Down syndrome star in a feature role, and it's great to see the diversity and disabilities on screen. I remember when I found out the daughter in A Quiet Place was actually deaf, and thought, like, if you have this platform and the character's integral to the story, why wouldn't you give out these opportunities to those with the actual disabilities? It does create a more genuine performance. The Peanut Butter Falcon is never mean in its portrayal of Down syndrome, and due to Zack Gottsagen's performance, it's incredibly raw and moving. You come to understand that through Zack's time at the care home, he's been treated differently for his disability, and he's lost faith in himself because of it. Tyler's able to deconstruct this perfectly through one line, when he says his Down syndrome has nothing to do with his heart. And this is exactly what we get from him. The first time we see Zack, he's taken his life into his own hands. He greases himself up and he slides straight out of the care home to go live his life and follow his dreams. Zack's such an inherently good character. I feel if he'd been written poorly, it could have been a bit overbearing, but as the writers have said in an interview, Zack is probably the most magnetic human you'll ever meet, and that's true. He's kind, he's witty, and his real-life friendship with Shia LaBeouf plays off beautifully.
And we should have our own secret handshake.
What kind of secret handshake? For what?
Buds, dudes, friends.
Buds, dudes, friends handshake?
All right, yeah.
Let's go, hurry up. All right, three of those, four of those. One of those, now what? Like that.
Yeah.
Just like in wrestling, you're there to make the other guy look good. And we see that between Shia and Zack. While Zack isn't the greatest actor of all time, he does bring a certain charm and wholesomeness to the scene. And Shia is there to pick up the acting chops and fill the scene with his presence. When we meet Tyler, he's already dealing with the loss of his brother. We soon discover that tragically, his brother had died at his hands when he fell asleep at the wheel. They don't explore their relationship too deeply in the film, but through LaBeouf, we see his immense grief and guilt, and we can see the great toll it's taken on who Tyler's already become. I feel the writing here is quite understated. It works as a great catalyst towards his and Zack's friendship. I see this as a way for Tyler to live in his memory of his older brother, taking Zack under his wing. He bestows life lessons onto him that he can only assume his brother once told him. The script is amazing. There's an honesty in the writing that you rarely get in films. There's many inspiring lines where everything's a bit more matter of fact without any of the sugarcoating.
Tyler, am I gonna die?
Yeah, you're gonna die. That's a matter of time. That ain't the question. Question is whether they're gonna have good stories to tell about you when you're gone. And don't be a bitch. Let's go.
The vast majority of the shots on this film are used on location, from South Carolina and Virginia, and the locations they choose are stunning. The film also utilises this sandy pastel filter, which enhances the untouched beauty of the setting. There are plenty of wide shots which communicate the vastness of the marshland, and I believe it's these shots which re-encapsulate the scope of their journey, and they're the ones that stay with you the longest.
Will you please help me? I'm scared, I can't swim!
I can't talk about this film without mentioning the nods to wrestling and the attention paid to it in its third act. When Zack and Tyler reach North Carolina, they meet Clint, played by Thomas Hayden Church, the real saltwater redneck. In what starts as a classic don't meet your hero storyline, he doesn't disappoint. He rocks up in his old gear and full 80s campiness.
I'm so happy to see you.
I'm happy to see you.
The saltwater then trains Zack and puts him on his next card. The final act gives us this quick redemption arc for the saltwater. He's someone who is way past his heyday, but he leaps at the chance to relive those old times, something that we sadly see all too often in wrestling. But thankfully, the saltwater must have recently seen Darren Aronofsky's The Wrestler or any of the WWE Dubai events and thought it's better to give something back. It's things like this that made me think that the writers really understood wrestling, not just for the spectacle, but for the grim reality that I think really got me back into the sport. Life's full of heroes and villains, and like Zack, it's all about overcoming the obstacles and just getting back up on your feet. Personally, I've really struggled during lockdown, and like many, I've not had any of my support groups, such as seeing my friends or any live music, or one thing that's been really important to me, the gym. It's been really difficult for me to watch my body change as to the extreme opposite of what I've worked really hard on over the past few years. And that's obviously much to my own fault. I've resorted to things like comfort foods and lay-ins. At first it was liberating to eat crap and get drunk, but over time it has really taken its toll. It's made me view myself in a very negative light and reflect poorly on how I think my friends and others see me. Thankfully, I've managed to start speaking about this with my partner and some friends, and they've all been incredibly supportive of me through all this. And sometimes all it does take is someone just to remind you all these doubts and negative thoughts you have about yourself are all just in your head. So never forget the importance of communication. Tell people how you're feeling. What matters really is just your opinion of yourself. A lot of the time, I don't view myself all that well, but when I do feel like I can achieve anything. Much like Zack, he feels like he's been persecuted through his life for his disability. But he knows he's the shit. And if those negative thoughts ever get the better of him, he just talks to his friend in Tyler, and he just reminds him that he is the shit.
Why do you want to be a bad guy?
Because my family left me.
It don't make you a bad guy. You're strong, Zack. Fuck your coach.
What I can learn from this film is that I just need to believe in myself a bit more and continue to surround myself with people that love me. Gyms are back open, so I'm leaping straight back into that, and I'm just going to become the best damn me that I can be, both mentally and physically, as it's never too late to turn it all around. This film comes in at around 97 minutes. That's usually a selling point in our house, so more films like that, please. The Peanut Butter Falcon is sweet, delightful and heartwarming. The heart of this movie is in the people that surround you, and instead of hamming it up, it creates a real believable bond between humans. It's fantastic performances all round. I didn't really mention Dakota Johnson, but she is equally as charming as the two leads, but Shia LaBeouf really is the standout. I'm not overly familiar with his films besides Transformers and Indiana Jones, so I'll be sure to check out what else he's done. This really is a story of friendship, support and progress, and if the past year has taught us anything, it's that these are the things that are most important in life. Just like Zack, you need to be the best you can be, And just like Tyler, she'd gas up your friends and be there to support their dreams and ambitions. Just pay it forward. I'm blessed that I've had the same great friends all my life, and I continue to find amazing people, and I'm thankful for that every day. This film really does look good, sounds good, and it feels good. Just watch this film with your buddies and bro dogs, chill, and have a good time.
Hey, what's rule number one? What's rule number one?
Party?
No, not party. No, it's not party. Don't slow me down. That's rule
number. Hey, thanks for checking out the video and sticking through to the end. That does really mean a lot. So the idea of these videos really is a way for me to track my gym progress. I used to do a lot of Instagram, and on there it would just be my big heavy lifts. This would be a great way for me to kind of vlog all the other exercises that I never really saw any of or never showed anyone of. I'm also trying to think this is a nice creative way for me to watch new content or play new games. Like, lockdown's been great for that. I've been able to watch loads more films, play more games than I ever really have. So I'm really thankful for that, COVID. It's been really, really kind of you. But yeah, as I said, thanks for sticking around. Please just let me know what you think down below. Like, comment, subscribe, all that. And I'll see you soon. Thanks a lot.